When we consider the quality of research, we need to consider reliability and validity. Singleton and Straits define reliability as the degree of stability and consistency. That is correct in the sense that empirically, when we evaluate reliability, we can take a look at stability and consistency, but that's a bit confusing definition. It's a lot simpler to understand reliability simply as whether we get the same result if we do the study again. So reliability is basically the degree of random error in the data. So if our measurements, if our study is unreliable, then repeating the measurement or study again would produce a different result. Reliable measurements and reliable studies always produce the same result. Then validity is concerned about whether the result is correct. So we can have a reliable measure that is not valid. For example, if we measure the intelligence of a person by measuring the circumference of their head using measurement tape, that would be highly reliable, but it is not a valid measure of intelligence. Reliability and validity can also be understood as precision and accuracy. So these are target practice diagrams, and there's someone shooting at the target. This shooter is highly reliable, always hitting the same spot, but he's not hitting the bull's eye. So this is a good shooter, but the sights are off, and it's reliable but not valid. This is a bad shooter, so he is not hitting the same spot, but the rifle has the sights correct, so this is valid but not reliable. So which one is the more serious problem? Some sources, such as Singleton and Straight, say that you can't have validity without reliability. And that is true if we just look at an individual shot here. So any individual hole on this target is very unlikely to be on bull's eye. So taking an individual spot from here would not tell us much. However, reliability can be improved by taking multiple measures from multiple studies. So if you have multiple unreliable things that are all valid, then taken together, those will produce valid conclusions. If we consider these two target practices, and we would have to stand in front of one of the targets, standing in front of this bull's eye would be perfectly safe because this guy will never hit the target. Here, if we stand in front of this target, we will eventually die if the person gets to shoot enough. So lack of reliability is less of a problem than lack of validity, because you can just repeat the study or repeat the measurement again and again, and eventually, on average, you will be correct. And in this case, a person standing in front of this target would die. Reliability and validity in quantitative research is typically considered through these five different kinds of reliabilities or validities. Because quantitative research is done using numbers, and we process those numbers with a computer, the idea is that there is no unreliability in the actual analysis. So when we focus on reliability, we typically focus on the reliability of measurement. So if we measure the same thing again, would we get the same result? Then we have four different kinds of or aspects of validity. The first one is measurement validity. Do the data that we have actually measure what they are supposed to measure? For example, we have this example from Talous et al. 500, where we were interested in whether naming a woman as a CEO causes profitability to increase. Then we need to consider whether our return on assets, which is the data here, is a valid measure of profitability. It probably is, because that's what managers like to use when they consider profitability, or investors like to use. Then statistical conclusion validity refers to the first condition of the three that are required for demonstrating causality. Statistical conclusion validity basically refers to whether we have identified the association correctly. So is it possible that this 4.7 percentage points difference is only because of chance, or is it evidence of a systematic difference between men and women-led companies? So that's the idea of statistical conclusion validity. Then internal validity refers to whether the second and third conditions for causality are true. So is the association actual valid evidence for causal relationship? Have we properly ruled out that it's not y that causes x, but it's actually x that causes y, and have we ruled out any alternate explanations? Then finally, external validity is about generalizability. So let's assume that we have established that there's a clear causal relationship that naming a woman as a CEO of one of the largest 500 Finnish companies causes profitability to increase. Can we say that that is true generally to all Finnish companies? Or can we say that that applies to all large companies in any country? So generalizability and external validity are about how broadly we can make our claim. So they are the things that we need to evaluate when we evaluate quantitative studies. In qualitative studies, sometimes we use the same terms. Of course, we don't do statistical conclusion validity, but how we actually go about evaluating them is slightly different.